Introducing the all-new 2018 Subaru Crosstrek at 2.9% financing on a Crosstrek today. Learn more at SubaruofKennesaw.com. Cannot be combined with any other incentive. Financing to well-qualified applicants. Subject to credit approval, vehicle insurance approval, and vehicle availability. No down payment required. See participating retailers for details. Offer expires 11/30/17.
Good evening and welcome to the Steve and Ed Show here on EOTM Radio. I want to thank you each for joining us tonight. As always, we'll be discussing the latest in entertainment news, sports, fashion, and movie reviews. Now tonight we welcome UK sensation Jahna Sebastian and Tanyka Renee from the WeTV reality show Match Made in Heaven. As always, once you call with your questions and comments, the number is 718-664-6543. Again, that's 718-664-6543. You can also join us in chat. There's a link on our Facebook page. Now, I also want to let you know that we're all over social media, as you know, Facebook, Twitter, Google+, Instagram, and our official website, thestevenightshow.com, where you can connect with us on social media there. And also send us emails, let us know your thoughts, and if you're an artist or a business owner or whatever, you want to be featured on our show, email us at submissions@thestevenightshow.com, and we'll definitely review it. Now, a quick program note, Adam, is on vacation in Australia. He's going to be there for the month of March. And he wants you all to connect with him on social media on his Instagram page, Fly as a Kite, so just the way it's pronounced, on Instagram. And you can see all his pictures and all of his experiences while he's over in Australia. So definitely check him out. Chike, what's going on with you?
Hey, brother. How are you?
I'm doing well. How are you doing?
I'm doing well.
That's good. That's good. So, Adam, you're by yourself for the month of March. Adam, he's in Australia.
I know. He abandoned me and went to Down Under.
Right. Well, I know you can handle it. How was your weekend?
My weekend was pretty good. You know, I'm in school, so my weekends now, since the beginning of the year, have been dedicated to school, so I really don't have too much of a weekend anymore. But,
yeah. You
know, it's an investment in self. I advise everyone, the biggest investment that you'll ever make will be in self. So find something
Absolutely.
To invest in, and it be you.
Absolutely. I definitely agree. I actually went to Virginia for the weekend to handle some things with my mother's estate. And I got some time to, you know, I was seeing my brother and his family and my dad and one or two friends. I didn't get to see a lot of friends. So I went there for a short period of time, but it was good being home. You know, obviously it's different because the home is different than when my mother was in there. But
right.
You know, it's part of the process. And you know, I got what I needed done. Got back here yesterday at 3:30. How'd you do with daylight saving time?
I don't do well with the sleeping part, but like when
right.
you jump into the work day, oh, it sails by. That's the part that's fun.
Yeah, right.
You look up and it's like noon already. Yeah.
That's true. And it's good getting off and having the sun still out, you know what I mean?
Yes, because you know me, I was dark in and dark out.
Exactly. Wow. Well, I think we're waiting on Ms. Parker. Well, actually, Ms. Parker's here. How you doing, Ms. Parker? You there? Yeah, I was told you there. Well, anyway, as you may know, Janera and Ms. Parker had their birthdays last week. Celebrated. Ms. Parker had a small dinner at this place called Tuk Tuk. It's a Thai spot. That food was off the chain. Ms. Parker, I'm told you're on. You there? Trying to have some technical difficulties, but yeah, it was great. The food was really good. They had the fried chicken, and then they had a salad. Well, veggies, I'm sorry, not veggies. Veggies, and there was one other thing I had. I can't remember. Oh, ribs. Really great. Great food.
I love Thai food.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, that restaurant, she told me, she said, I told you the food was good. But, you know, prior to that, she went to Miami, but she really brought it in. So it was good to celebrate her 30th with her. Well, I'll let you go ahead, Chika, and go into movie reviews.
Okay, so I went to go check out the hype of this 50 Shades of Grey. Now, I understood the premise of the movie before I went, and I did not read the books, but from what I understand, there was a lot of innuendos, like small little minute things left out of the movie, of course, that were in the book, which happens. But in me watching the movie, I did not get all the details that, you know, I didn't get the story, I guess, as it was meant to be from watching the movie. And there were, it reminded me of another movie that came out many, many years ago, starring Mickey Rourke and Kim Basinger, called 9½ Weeks. And the premise of 50 Shades of Grey is two people meet, which is Dakota Johnson and Jamie Dornan, I think his name is. And they begin a love affair with a very different kind of sex life. He's a sadist.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And he pretty much turns her out. And it's interesting at the end of the movie, and I know this movie is told in series because the books are in series. I guess there's going to be another part.
I didn't understand. Too.
What'd you say? I'm sorry.
They already planned to schedule to shoot the two more movies.
At the end of it, honestly, I was saying, why? I mean, and I get it. At the end, I was like, well, why are you doing this? And yeah. I understand the backstory. And if they had detailed the writing more to tell some of the backstory and why these people were the way they were, like they did in the book, then the movie would have purpose for me.
Right.
But
right, yeah.
I think that the initial hype, because it came out like the week of Valentine's Day, that's the week that it came out.
Mm-hmm.
It came out to sold out tickets. Like,
right.
You couldn't get a ticket to go see this movie. And I just didn't understand the hype. I guess everyone ran and flocked to the movie because of the book success.
Mm-hmm.
And
mm-hmm.
the books were really good from what I hear. But the movie just didn't live up to the hype of the book, nor did it live up to those sold out ticket sales to me. I was saying, why at the end? I turned to look at people that were sitting next to me. Did you get it? Did you understand? And they were like, oh. Like, even women that say they have read the book, they were like, oh. So,
yeah, they
said
a lot of people were disappointed. They were disappointed.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And then because there's a lot of S&M, they can't do that without getting a, staying in PG-13. So they couldn't show a lot. And so a lot of the people that read the book, they were disappointed by that as well.
Hey, I say go for the NC-17 or go for the X and then make it the movie that it's supposed to be. And you probably would make more money. I'm just saying.
Yeah, that's true. That's true.
So those people that went to go see 50 Shades of Grey, I'm giving it a thumbs down, yes. But if you want to see a movie that someone liked 50 Shades of Grey and better, I suggest you go back to the vault of yesterday and check out 9½ Weeks with Mickey Rourke and Kim Basinger. Just saying.
Get more for your money, huh?
Yeah.
Anything else that you saw?
That's the only movie I saw. I'm actually looking for a Divergent sequel, Insurgent, I believe. And then there's this movie, Tracers, which stars Taylor Lautner. Well, he puts out good action movies. I'm looking for that. And that's pretty much on my radar for right now. Marvel has some movies coming out, too, but they're going to be coming out probably around May, just for the summer.
Okay. Right, yeah, yeah. All right. Well, I know you'll be sticking on for Hot Topics later on, but thank you for now, okay?
Absolutely.
All right. And we have Ms. Parker. What's going on, Ms. Parker?
Hey, what's going on? I was on. I'm not sure why you guys weren't hearing me, but happy Monday.
Happy Monday. Happy Monday. How was your weekend?
Weekend was good. It was short. I'm trying to find a word. Very short.
Right.
But it was good.
You did something exciting yesterday. You want to tell us about it?
Yep. So last Wednesday was my birthday. I heard you discuss that for a second. I really appreciate everybody who showed me mad love on Instagram, text messages, calling, sending flowers, gifts, everything. I really appreciate
yeah.
it. Amazing 30th, and I am grateful for you all.
30-30.
Yep, 30-30. It was amazing. I'm looking forward to it. But, yes, as far as yesterday, I'm so dog tired now, and I worked out today. The Spartan race with a few friends. If you guys are not aware, Spartan is similar to Tough Mudder. I think most people know about Tough Mudder. I did Tough Mudder last year. That's 11 miles and 17 obstacle courses. So I was like, oh, I got this. Because Spartan only 5 miles. So I was like, man, I got this. But Spartan was a lot more challenging.
Was it?
Obstacle courses, and obstacle courses were a lot more tougher. So ever again, when I'd be like, oh, yeah, I got this, and then I know I'm going into it. Someone had warned me. I was like, I think it's tougher than Tough Mudder. I'm like, nah, I couldn't be because Tough Mudder is twice as long. But I think their goals are different. I think Tough Mudder challenges your endurance, and Spartan challenges your strength with all the obstacle courses. But it was fun. It was a good experience.
Good. How long were you out there?
I completed in 2 hours, and that's an okay time. I could have probably done it faster, but I had a couple of friends who were doing it for the first time, so I stayed in the back with them the first half, and then the second half I was like, I gotta leave y'all.
Right.
I feel so bad because I'm so competitive, not just standing around and waiting was starting
right.
to get to me.
Yeah.
So,
I'm
not competitive with anyone else. I'm competitive with myself. I like doing the best I can, whatever I'm doing. So it's not if I was in competition with somebody else. No, I'm not competitive in that way at all. But I wanted to do my best, and I felt like waiting around wasn't doing my best. Maybe I had to get over that and just maybe just
right.
have fun with it. But the next one I do, my trainer and I are going to actually try to do one together, and we're going to try to do it as a competition because you can do a different league. Where you're actually competing, and see if we can place or something. Just as another challenge. But yeah, it was fun. It's just something different I'm doing. I like doing physical stuff, and it was the dirtiest one I've ever done. It was like so much mud to crawl through. Like my hair, my eyes, it was covered in mud. At one point, I couldn't even see. I had a bag for some water to wipe my eyes off. Because you're like covered in mud, yeah. So it's an exciting experience.
Well, yeah, I know a lot of trainers that I follow. They always say, yeah, it's good to get in the gym, but also getting outside the gym and doing things like that, and doing, you know, like when you even do Stone Mountain or whatever, you know, that's also good too. You know, just to switch it up.
Yeah, what it does is
challenge
keeps you excited about working out, because I think
right.
most people get tired of working out because they feel like working out has to be in the gym. But I try to get out and do different things, and I switch up my workouts, and I may work out by myself one day. I may go to boot camp. Like, you got to switch it up, and you got to keep it exciting, and find things that you like to do, and challenge yourself, and keep it fresh. If you just go into the gym on the treadmill and say, you're not going to see results, first of all, you're not going to be motivated to want to keep doing it. So
Exactly. That's good stuff as partner, definitely. Well, Aaron, what's going on with you, man?
Hola, ¿cómo estás?
Hola, how you doing?
Hola, I'm tired. Sorry.
Bien,
it just came out. How are you?
It's like that hour extra that we got now is kind of playing with everybody a little bit. People.
It's funny
because
I went to bed extra early too. I went to bed early, and it still didn't work.
Right.
I woke up. I'm, you know, overslept today because, you know, my body's already programmed for, you know, before the push forward. So that's crazy.
It's funny because your body does still wake up at the same time. And I think my body's not used to waking up at the hour I woke up. Even though I went to bed earlier, it's still a little bit confused. But I do like the fact that it's light out later.
Yeah.
Exactly. Right.
Yeah.
I do too.
So we just have to give ourselves another couple of weeks until our bodies adjust.
Right. Exactly.
That's it.
So how was your weekend, Aaron? What'd you do?
My weekend was really nice. I went to a Mardi Gras charity event party. It was really nice. It was to help raise money for a summer youth camp. So it was really nice.
So nice. Yeah.
I wore I wore a mask and had the beads and everything. It was really nice. And they had great food. Oh, New Orleans style food.
New Orleans. Yeah.
Oh, thank you.
It was great.
Very much so. Very, very much so.
That's good.
Yeah.
Good stuff.
Yes,
what's
going
on in the wonderful world of sports?
Ah, sports. Well, you all know that it's March, so of course, March Madness.
March Madness.
Is upon us. I see. As far as teams that are already in, aren't many. A few that actually won their conference championship games, and my iPad is locked up, so I can't even click on that. All right, so we'll move on from that. What's going on? Oh, gosh. NBA. Hawks are still playing very well. Why is my iPad working? Sorry, y'all, my iPad. Screw it. Hawks are doing great. Derrick Rose is still hurt. He's up for the – they're saying that he could actually be back before the season ends. So,
Yeah.
So do I think he should come back early? No. I actually think that he should wait until the playoffs or just wait to see. I mean, let's be real, y'all. The Bulls are not going to win the championship. They're not going to go to the Eastern Conference Finals. So if I was wrong at the long, as far as with me playing next year and you're a year after that, I would just pretty much chill out for this
year.
But if he feels he can come back this season to help the Bulls, more power to him, but I don't think it's really worth it. But who am I? Because I have I enjoy watching the Hawks play basketball. I don't know what it is, but they are really good. They're great. They shut LeBron James down. Like, they shut him down. Miss Parker, wow. Kudos. So, are y'all going to any playoff games for the Hawks?
Yeah.
Y'all got your
tickets? I don't know. We don't have any tickets yet. We need to go out there and support them. They're doing so well.
I was on mute for some reason. Sorry about that. I heard you about the playoffs. Atlanta is doing well, and I was thinking about going to one of the games. But, being in Atlanta for 8 years, everything just gets so groupie-like. You know what I mean? Like, you're in the games, but, it's just too much. Like, Atlanta is just too Hollywood at times. So you can't.
You got all the stars, celebrities.
It's gonna be a whole show and everything. So I don't know.
Yeah,
it's gonna
become
some
more of a
make it happen. But
Well, if y'all don't want to go, Stephen, Miss Parker, since we got this big old Stephen Knight Show budget,
gave me some free tickets, I'm going to definitely go purchase some tickets. Nah, I ain't going to happen.
We'll see what we can do.
Coach, you ain't even got to give me first class. Yeah. You can fly me coach.
Fly your coach.
You can fly me coach. Give me half-court tickets, court-side tickets. Sit me behind the basket. You ain't even got to sit me on the sideline. Behind the basket, I'm good. Right there, live. Stephen Knight Show. I'm telling you, playoffs.
We'll see what
Ladies
we can
and
do.
Send your messages for Ron to go to the Hawks playoff game to Stephen Knight. Go
you
to his Facebook
go,
page.
You should do a GoFundMe.
We should do a GoFundMe. Ron.
To the game.
Amen. Yes, sir. But that's pretty much it in sports, man. Like, it's like one of those times now, it's kind of popping off yet. But next week, we'll actually talk about bracketology. So you all will have your brackets ready and stuff, and we can kind of see who's going to do what in the tournament next week. So I'll definitely be talking about that big time. And all right, y'all going to talk about Empire and
We're gonna talk about it on
Christina's boyfriend and all this crying and stuff that he's doing on Dr. Phil. Talking about that.
we're gonna talk about the Aaron.
Okay, cool. Well, I can't wait. Yo, follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, Aaron Cosby. I can't wait to hear this. I'm out. Talk to y'all next week.
I'm gonna do a hot topic. She's sticking around, right?
Oh yeah. I'm sorry.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. Miss Ferguson, what's going on?
Hey, what's going on? How you doing?
Good. Did you have a good birthday week?
Ferguson, happy belated birthday and congratulations.
Thank you. Yeah.
Oh, my God. I'm so excited for you.
I'm so terrified for me.
Oh, no. You're awesome. If you do any as well as you treat that dog, you'll
right.
be fine.
Look, I said if the dog and my baby don't get along, the baby got to go.
Oh,
so we'll see.
You can get me. I'll take the baby then. I'm volunteering, okay?
Oh, okay. Hey, look.
You
now,
know
everybody
what
on radio still heard it, right? And all the audience heard, so don't try to take it back.
I got you. Do you know what you're having?
What did you say? Yeah, we're having a boy.
Oh,
wow.
So cute. Congratulations.
Wow. Congratulations.
Yeah.
That's great. That's awesome.
Yeah, we were holding that one in for a while, but you know, I can't. I'm showing now. I can't hold it in anymore.
How far along are you?
I'll be 20 weeks on Thursday.
How many months is that?
well, it's a little under five. It's a little under five.
Okay.
I mean, you know, some people look at 20 weeks as 5 months, but I'm looking at it from like, you know, the beginning of the month to the end of the month, because you know a lot of people just say 4 weeks is 1 month. So I guess
yeah.
it just all depends on how you look at it.
Okay.
Just promise
yeah,
me one
I'm
thing that you won't be. Just be promise me one thing, Jared. You won't be one of those mothers that when they ask you how old your baby is, oh, he's 96 months.
No, that baby be 1, 2.
Right.
Yeah. Once, I think once the baby hit 12 months, it's time for you to stop saying months and just say years.
Right.
Yeah.
Right. Exactly.
Yeah. Once he hits 12 months, I promise you, I will not be that person trying to make people add. I promise you. Don't worry.
She would just walk away confused. Okay.
Right. So if he could,
that's
what
I'm like, oh, okay. 27 months. Okay, cool.
Right.
You want to tell him happy birthday?
27 weeks, I mean.
Right. So,
but what do you
yeah.
have for us? Let me get some great stuff for us.
I do. And I'm so sorry. Last week I was so bogged down with work, I did not have a chance to update anything. So hopefully tonight I can redeem myself. But I do have a couple of things for everybody. Old Navy and Gap, they're having a sale. This sale ends today. It started yesterday and ends tonight. If you shop there now, you can get 35% off of your purchase. And if you're shopping online, you have to use code DAYLIGHT. And, of course, this is in honor of Daylight Savings. And Banana Republic was affiliated with Gap and Old Navy. They're also having a sale, but they are they're discounting everything 40% off because, you know, everybody who shops at Banana Republic, Old Navy, and Gap knows that, you know, that it's basically like Banana Republic is the top tier, Gap second tier, and Old Navy is pretty much the bottom tier. So, I mean, I actually shop at them all. You know,
I love Old Navy.
Yeah, I do too. I actually was just in there. I got some of my maternity clothes from Old Navy. So, and if anybody is in the mood, if anybody's in the market for any maternity clothes, I would suggest going to Old Navy because, like, they have stuff like $7. I mean, you really can't
wow.
beat that. Yeah, I got, like, a couple of dresses and everything. I said, yeah, we can do this. So,
exactly.
But, yeah, they're very, very inexpensive. And, it still looks good. So, I happen to love Old Navy. But, you know, Banana Republic is also having their sale. And if you shop there now and use code DAYLIGHT, you can get 40% off. Nordstrom Rack is having a sale. And I'm not sure, for those of you ladies who out there who know what Trina Turk is, she's a very high-end designer. And Nordstrom Rack actually is having a sale on Trina Turk items. So you can go out there and go to Nordstrom Rack. And actually Nordstrom Rack and Halt Look, they're affiliated. So you may have to have either a Nordstrom Rack login or a Halt Look login in order to be able to shop there. But the savings are great. So I would just suggest, you know, all you have to do is just sign up with an email, you know, with an email address and, you know, and the password. So it's not too hard. Express is having a sale, and this is for guys and girls. For every $25 you spend, you get, I'm sorry, you get $25 off of every $100 you spend, excuse me. Plus, you can get sandals, tees, and tanks starting at just $14.90 and shorts starting at just $29.90. So they're obviously getting ready for spring, which means that they are trying to deeply discount, you know, all the winter and fall items. So I would say that this is definitely the time to start looking for winter and fall items just to start stocking up your closet. Aries having a sale today only, and, you know, that's like affiliated with American Eagle. But they're having a sale, and, well, it's not really a sale, but you can get free shipping on everything today only. So if you guys want to go out there and shop, and this does include sale items, which is the only thing I will go to anyway, you know. As a limited, it's having a sale. And if you shop there now, you can get 30% off of their Ashton blouses. That's just the type of blouse they have, and it's like they're they usually have one front runner type blouse per season, and this season is Ashton. Plus, you can buy one, get one free on all jackets, suits, jackets, pants, skirts, and dresses. So if you guys are looking for any suits, you know, if you ladies out there are looking for any suits, you definitely can go to the Limited and buy one, get one free. And, again, that's on all jackets, pants, dresses, and skirts. Plus, you can get 40% off of full price items. Plus, you can get an extra 30% off of clearance items. So that may be something that you guys want to think about. And last but not least, in honor of Fashion Week, this is my favorite sale of the day, simply because I can sometimes be like a label crazy person, but I never want to pay like big prices for my labels.
Right.
Bluefly.com, they're having a sale right now on designer brands. You can get up to 75% off if you're interested in making that type of purchase, or some people call it an investment. I fool myself, I call it an investment. Yeah, you know how I am. But, you know, if you decided to, you can definitely get up to 75% off of brands like Christian Louboutin, Jimmy Choo, Fendi, Gucci, all of those brands. Now, listen to what I said. I said up to 75% off, not 75%
right.
off. So just be careful about that because, you know, I don't want you to go out there thinking I'm lying. Something is only 30% off, but
right,
definitely
right.
check that out if you're in the market for any type of designer goods.
Can
and that's
I
all I have
you,
to buy this evening.
Can I ask you, are you excited about buying baby clothes?
I'm actually not, and here's why. Because I'm thinking, and my mom's like, it's not going to be that bad. So I'm like, okay, so all my money's going to go to him now. And I'm still thinking this. I know it's like the most selfish thing in the world. So those of you out there, please don't judge me. I'm old enough to have a child. I'm not that immature. But
right.
I did start thinking. I was like, oh, my God, I won't be able to buy myself anything ever again in life. So we'll see, though. We'll see. Yes, but I do.
Yeah.
I do have my eye on a couple of things that I like to get them. But, of course, everything will be on sale. So
Right.
Yeah.
Well,
that's
thank
true.
You so much, and they can find all your sales at budgetshophollywood.com. Go there and check it out. And thanks again, and congratulations again, and have a great week.
Thank you so much. Okay, and happy belated birthday, Ms. Parker.
But thank you. Same to you.
Okay, I'll talk to you guys later.
All right, Chike, Aaron, and Ms. Parker, you ready to get these hot topics?
Yes, sir.
Ready
how
it can be.
Mm-hmm. All right.
Absolutely.
Well, a lot of you have heard of University of Oklahoma's Sigma Alpha Epsilon fraternity members have been allegedly implicated in a video showing members participating in a racist rant, and the fraternity was under investigation. Then today it came out later today that the students have been suspended and the frat has been shut down off of the campus. They were making, you know, doing a racist chant, using the N-word, and it's an all-white fraternity. And so, of course, the campus is in an uproar, and as well as people all over the country. What are your thoughts?
This is why I'm not a fan of anybody using the N-word, because I'm sure those guys didn't really think that it was a big deal. You know what I mean? Like, I'm not excusing their actions. I think that, and honestly, I wouldn't even go as far as calling them racist. I think they're ignorant. I think it's more ignorance than racism. But I think that that's where we need to really rethink our community using the N-word as well, because I think what it does is it gives people permission to think that it's okay. And I saw an older gentleman on there.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know. I guess because I don't know the entire story, I don't want to be too quick to pass judgment. I'm not the type of person to quickly form opinions about stuff like this. But
okay.
I wouldn't be surprised if he has something to do with influencing them to do that, because usually younger Americans, younger white people are not outwardly racist. You know what I mean?
Right.
It's very hard to find a group of 20 young men are just outwardly racist, white men sitting together. Like, I find that a little odd, so I would like to know
mm-hmm.
a little bit more about the history. But either way, they should be suspended. There should be some action taken against them. And I think that us as a community need to rethink the whole word as well as far as how we use it.
Okay. Aaron?
I was disgusted by it. I agree with Ms. Parker that the N-word is wrong, period, whether you're white, black, green, and blue. It's a nasty word. Now, with the actual chant, I also heard, and this is what really ached me up, because saying the N-word, you know, it's wrong, but whatever. It's not what you call, it's what you answer to. That's how I feel.
Mm-hmm.
But
mm-hmm.
but it's wrong. It's a dirty word. But they also were saying in the chant, talking about hanging.
Right.
A N-word.
I forgot about that.
Right.
Yeah.
What they
and
were saying,
that's when it took it to like a whole, to me, like a whole nother level.
Right.
Yeah.
You
know what I mean?
Yeah.
What they were saying, let's be clear, they were saying that no N-word is going to join, and they call it SEA. That's the abbreviation for their chapter.
Right.
They can hang from a tree, but they'll never join this fraternity.
Right.
Right.
That's what
right.
They were saying.
It did say that.
Okay,
Chike? It sounds like a threat to me.
Yeah,
I'm
hello?
Just saying. It sounds
right.
like a little threat.
Right.
Yeah.
Aren't threats
well, you
against
know,
the law?
Right, right. And, you know, but what I did like was this, is that I was watching a show and they said that, you know, anywhere you go, there are going to be people who think this way, say these kind of things. But the proudest moment is that it didn't take a day for the school to take action, to show this is
right.
not right behavior, and we won't condone that. And so that's what
yeah.
I like, that they were stopped in their tracks before it really got out of hand. You know, the video went viral, now the chapter's
it's closed.
You know,
the chapter is closed. It's closed.
And the students have been suspended. So,
and
I
they will probably be expelled. More than likely, these students will be expelled out of school for good, out of the university. So,
mm-hmm. yeah.
Things are called.
It seems like no matter what we do, we just can't escape the N-word. There was another issue on Empire where Terrence Howard wanted to incorporate it into the script.
Mm-hmm,
he wants to
mm-hmm.
use it on the show. And his argument is that it makes it more realistic because in real life we use the word amongst ourselves.
Right.
And there was
he
an interview with a writer of the show, and they asked him, and the writer happened to be Caucasian, and they asked him, and he said, well, I can't weigh in on that. He said, it's not, there's no justification for me to weigh in on it. You would have to ask some of the African-American writers because I would never touch it. He said,
mm-hmm.
just simply because it's a hot subject and I would never touch it. I
right.
think that it would taint the show if you incorporated that into it.
Right.
It's my
right.
opinion.
I think so too.
Yeah. I think I'm watching, including myself, because I think that, you know, just how we feel when these type of videos are shown with, you know, a majority of white people using the N-word. And then, like, it's to me almost like a death penalty, right? How do you say killing is wrong when you go and kill somebody? Like, I don't understand
mm-hmm.
how you could justify using the N-word and then say it's wrong for them to use it. You know what
right.
I mean? Like, I guess the explanation that had been used to justify that doesn't make sense to me.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, you're right. I'm sorry, go ahead. Steve, I'm sorry.
Let's move next to our first guest here, so I want to get through couple more topics before we go. Nick Gordon, Bob Christina's boyfriend, who, you know, Bob Christina, she's in an inducing coma, and she's in at the hospital. She's been in there for a few months now, I believe. Well, he's doing an interview with Dr. Phil. They released a clip, you know, promoting the interview. It's coming on Wednesday. And in the interview, he's talking about how he misses Whitney, he misses Bob Christina, and that he hates Bobby Brown, and that apparently he admits to Dr. Phil that he's been drinking a lot lately. So Dr. Phil wants him to go into rehab. The clip they showed, he said, I want you to go to rehab right now. And the clip is Nick saying, this interview is over. What are your thoughts on him doing an interview with Dr. Phil?
Can I say this? Can I speak first on this, Stephen? But I think that Nick Gordon, there's something about his energy I don't like. I think he is a media whore. I think he is capitalizing on a tragic event. I have an issue with his mother being sitting there right beside him, her son was raised with Whitney Houston with another
right
person. So, you know, there's just a lot going on there that just reeks to me. It smells.
Right.
Mm-hmm. I'm not feeling him at all. And he got paid for that interview intervention with Dr. Phil. So.
Okay. Okay.
Next. Go ahead. Y'all go ahead.
All right. Ms. Barber?
No, I agree. I think he is an opportunist. I think that but I do also think that he's an addict. I think he's young. I think he's going through the same type of dysfunction as Bobby Christine. I think that he does need help. And I think going to rehab, whether or not she makes it through, will probably be the best thing he's done for himself. And I think that even if she does make it through, it will probably be the best thing he's done for himself and her, because that way he can be in a better mind frame to help her maybe pull out emotionally if she is able to pull out physically.
Okay. And she got.
Well, I believe that, he has been iced out, so he's trying to have a voice at this point. And let's all please keep in mind that there still is a criminal investigation happening surrounding Bobby Chris and how she got to where she is now. And he is a part of that criminal investigation. So I believe that he's going to do whatever he can on his end to try to preserve whatever decent image he has, or try to claim some type of innocence. But he has a voice and he's trying to use it. We don't know if he's being coached by counsel or whatever, but he's under investigation.
It'll be interesting to see the interview. It's on Wednesday, so if you get a chance, watch it, and we'll talk about it next week. Last topic before we go to break. The year 2020, we could see a woman on the front of the $20 bill. Candidates that have been discussed, Harriet Tubman, Sigourney Truth, Rosa Parks, Shirley Chisholm, Barbara Jordan, Eleanor Roosevelt, Susan B. Anthony, and a few others. Who would you like to see?
Ms. Parker, you want to go first with that one?
I don't know. I have to give that one some thought. I can't pick right up the top.
Yeah, it's a lot of people.
A lot. Yeah. They're all great. I mean, they were great women. That's tough.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
I would just say, being that we have yet to have an African-American person on currency, it would be great if the woman was African American. Now, which woman do I choose? It's tough. I mean, they're all great women, so it's tough. Yeah,
it's hard. It's hard.
Yeah.
She can win.
I'm all about baby steps. whatever woman that they decide to put on will be cool with me. It's just nice to see your female represented.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm. Well, listen, y'all. Thank y'all so much. Y'all have a great week. Before we go to commercial, question of the day. What do you do when you know someone has a crush on you but you have no interest? Tweet us at Stephen Knight Show, SHO, or go on our Facebook page, The Stephen Knight Show, and let us know your thoughts. We'll write back after this.
You're listening to The Stephen Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. You're listening now. You're listening to the Steve and Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. The Steve and Knight Show, Monday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on EOTMRadio.com.
Welcome back. Jahna Sebastian is a classically trained piano on piano and earned a degree in music business at the age of 20. Last year she released her EP, At the Edge of Love, that's currently available. I want to please help me welcome the very talented UK-based sensation, Jahna Sebastian. Welcome to the show.
Hi. How are you doing?
I'm good. How are you?
I'm good, thank you.
I'm glad you know, I was reading up on you. First of all, 19 years in the industry, and you sing, you act, you produce, perform, do engineers, mix your own music. I mean, you're the woman doing it all. You're doing it all. How did this all start for you 19 years ago?
Well, music has always been a part of my life. So, you know, I started singing, you know, when I started talking pretty much. And then I started playing in the children's orchestra at the age of 7. And that's how I learned to read music. Then when I was 11, I had a personal revelation where I decided that I wanted to become a professional musician. And pretty much, you know, that was like my first paid job, you know, as well, around the same time as playing in the orchestra for like Christmas events. As a child. And then, then I just proceeded. And when I was 16, I entered the Russian Academy of Music and done 5-year course, like the degree. And I started performing with different bands. And eventually I just was so fascinated with, you know, like that I, you know, was playing around with, you know, trying to make beats, you know, even when I was like 15, 16. But then I took it more seriously when I came to London and I set up my own studio. When I was like about 20. And so pretty much it just was like I was just like adding one after another, you know, the live bands, the performance, the recording with various artists, and then eventually, you know, basically learning to engineer and produce myself and other artists as well.
Wow. And, you know, engineering and there are a lot of female producers, but in terms of doing the actual engineer work, it's more of a male-dominated industry. How's it like being a female, you know, having your own studio and doing this? How does that feel? What's your experience?
Yeah, it's true. It's a very male-dominated field.
Mm-hmm. Right.
But I think, you know, if you're really good at something, you know, it doesn't really matter, you know, whether you're a woman or a man. To be honest, you know, I just found that quite a few times I'll have, you know, men come in to record in my studio because basically I was the best person to provide the service they needed. Yeah, so they tried out other studios, you know, with male engineers, obviously, because, you know, there were no other female engineers. And for some reason, they came back to me and said, like, well, Jahna, you know, I think you're the best person to do this job. So I just believe, you know, there are a lot of, I think, you know, I did ask some female singers, you know, on the way as well, like, why don't you try to engineer or produce? And the main reason would be that they say it's either too geeky, you know, it's too technical,
right,
or they'll feel sometimes a bit intimidated. But, you know, I think, like, you know, in UK and it's the same thing in America, you know, if you really want to break into the field, the best thing is to be professional. And at the same time, you have to also, you know, play the game right. Like, for example, you can't like mix like, you know, pleasure and, you know, and business. So when you work with men, you know, in the industry, you know, you have to be professional about everything. Do you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So I've been
yeah.
in a studio with guys and there have to be boundaries. That's the only challenge is obviously when you're a girl.
Right. Yeah.
You know, so you have to
hit on you.
Well, you know, it's not a problem, you know what I'm saying? But it's just something that you have to be aware of, that, you know, if you're working on a project, that's it. You know, that's it. You just you have to finish this mixtape or this album, you know, and nothing else needs to be mixed in because, you know, emotional stuff. So if your relationship is a bit different. You know, it has to be, like, very, very professional. You know, and but I believe, you know, that, yeah, as long as you become the master of, you know, of the, you know, the field, it's possible to achieve the best. I was just always interested in computers and technology. I wanted to, when I was a kid, I wanted even to do, like, C++ programming course.
Oh, did you? Okay.
Yeah. So I guess you have to, like, have both sides of the brain to work in that direction, the creative and the analytical side.
Right. Yeah. Well, you know, I read that when you were 3 months pregnant, you were detained at Yarrow's World Detention Center for 3 months. While you were detained at that center while you were 3 months pregnant for 2 months. Tell us about the experience.
Yeah. Well, Yarrow's Detention Center is the infamous the immigration detention center in UK. Basically, it's infamous because there are a lot of people there that shouldn't be there. And basically, I claimed political asylum when I came to UK because I had to save my life when I was leaving Russia because I was standing up against racism and racist groups, organized groups in Russia, you know, through my music, through attending demonstrations and protests, through speaking up in the media. And then eventually got to the point where I had to basically secretly move to London. And when I started, I had to start my life from scratch here. However, you know, I claimed political asylum. And at some point, basically, when I came for the interview, my case was dealt with, you know, like unprofessionally and in the wrong procedure. So it was pretty much illegal imprisonment.
Yeah.
Like they just sent me there without even looking at my case properly. So I was pregnant at the time, and to be honest, you know, I had a house, you know, and, like, I had a property in UK. I had everything, you know, set up. There was absolutely no reason for me to be excluded from society this way. But I've seen some crazy experiences there, yeah?
Yeah,
and,
I can imagine.
I spent Christmas that year and New Year's Eve, basically.
Wow.
You know, and when I came out, I was, like, 5 months pregnant. And basically my case went to the High Court. I wrote to the Queen. I got a letter from Buckingham Palace. You know, I wrote to everyone. And then eventually, you know, it took about 2 years for my case to be resolved. And then I eventually won my case, you know, after a few court, court appearances and had to, you know, sign on like every 2 weeks or something. It was just really bizarre because I never thought that, you know, it wasn't like I've never done anything like to be convicted or anything like that. And it wasn't a conviction. It was kind of, you know, just the wrong procedure that at that point they were changing the immigration law and they were trying to get rid of as many people as possible from UK. So it didn't really matter. But there were people that were coming from certain parts in the, you know, in the world, which were, like, clearly very, you know, dangerous.
Yeah,
it was...
that was an experience I can imagine. So you had your daughter in 2008, and her father is Swiss Beats. How's your relationship with him?
You know, he's great. You know, he's a great father.
Good.
You know, so,
good.
And he loves Nicole, and Nicole is
good.
He has, like, a very special relationship with him. So.
Yeah. Well, good. Well, let's talk about The Edge of Love. That was your EP, your last EP, The Edge of Love. Tell us about that EP and what was your inspiration behind that and, you know, kind of what you want people to take away after listening to it.
That's right. The Edge of Love is inspired by my personal experiences, you know, with relationships and, you know, the extreme emotions that, you know, they can bring, going from love to hate, you know, and having like, and from hate to love, you know, like, having like this thin line, you know, just exploring, you know, the depth of emotions. And yeah, basically it was like the songs there I wrote about how I felt, you know, about certain situations. And you know, there's a song, The Edge of Love, which is obviously the title track, and it's about like having like this like really strong emotions, you know, like on the edge, you know. And
right,
that's
yeah.
why the video is about like me appearing as an alien, you know, like I'm so
right,
on the edge
right.
that I need to steal the guy, you know, show him my world.
Right, right.
But
yeah.
But then there is, on another hand, there is poison, which is like when you're in love with someone and it's not really good for you at all, but you're still coming back there, you know, it's like a drug.
Right.
You know, and you come to realization, but at the same time you keep, you know, coming back. It's like the sweetest taboo, you know.
Right,
and
right.
Yeah, there's other tunes as well, you know, going about this subject. So yeah, it's like,
yeah.
like you know, it's like I look at it like an EP, you know, genuinely is like a book, you know, with a few chapters that tell
exactly.
the story, you know, unfolded.
Yeah. And where can people purchase? They can purchase on your website, obviously. Where else can they purchase this EP?
Yes, they can definitely get it from iTunes,
okay.
Amazon, also Bandcamp, pretty much every, you know, major store online.
Right.
They can
right.
get it from my website, Jahna Sebastian.
Yes.
And also I have another EP as well. It's called I Am Free, which
I'm
is
free,
out as
yes.
well.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
And I've got the third one on the way, which will also be available very soon. It's called Love Over Hate.
Okay, okay. Well, you're doing big things. And, you know, what impressed me the most about you is that you're doing it all. You're doing the singing, the writing, the production, the actual engineering. You know, that's awesome. That's awesome. So we wish you nothing but success. Tell everybody where they can connect with you online.
Oh, thank you. Yes, you can follow me on Twitter. At Jahna Sebastian, Instagram at Jahna Sebastian, Facebook Jahna Sebastian World, my website jahnasebastian.com, and also my YouTube channel. My main YouTube channel is Multivision Music. I've got like all my music videos there and some exclusives. And yeah, also you can contact through Kathy. To my publicist, you know, for any inquiries
yeah.
about like beats and songs and collaborations, I'm always open to working with artists, you know, producers.
Yes,
all over the world.
And we're going to play some of your music in our next half hour, but I want to thank you so much for taking the time to join us. You have a great night, okay?
Thank you so much for having me.
Thank you. You take care.
Thank you. You have a great night as well.
Thank
take
you so
care.
Much. Thank you. Thank you. Right back after this with Tanyka Renee. After this message.
You're listening to The Stephen Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. You're listening now. You're listening to The Stephen Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. The Stephen Knight Show, Monday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on EOTMRadio.com.
Welcome back. Tanyka is an accomplished athlete who has done some high fashion runway modeling in Paris and Monaco. Her athletic career includes playing in a women's 7-on-7 tackle football league. She's currently recently divorced, is ready to find the man of her dreams. I love this. She tries to follow the advice her mother gave her. Be a good cook and give good head to the man. She can be seen on Wee TV's hit reality show, Match Made in Heaven. Please help me welcome Tanyka Renee. Welcome to the show.
Hi, thank you.
Hi.
You know I'm going to kill you because you pronounced my name wrong.
Oh, I'm sorry. Tell me right. How is it?
It's Tanyka.
Tanyka, I'm sorry, it's spelled
yes. T-A-N-Y-K-A. Y-K-A, yes.
Okay, Tanyka, I apologize for that. Tanyka Renee, welcome to the show. Mm. Welcome.
Thank you.
Your mother's a wise woman. I love her already.
You know, I grew up in a household very, very honest with each other.
Yeah, yeah. Well, how do you think that kind of, you know, your mother being that honest with you, telling you this is what you need to do, you know, to keep your man happy, whatever, how did that, you know, make you the woman you are today? How did that, you know, kind of go with you?
Well, I just, I'm very open. I feel like a lot of women today, they're, you know, they're not aware and they're in denial a lot.
Mm-hmm.
Especially when it comes to their relationship.
Right.
I feel like, you know, when it comes to love, love is about pleasing the other person.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel like a lot of women, it's about pleasing themselves, or, you know, they're worried about them and their ego.
Right. Right. Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
So
I wasn't raised like that.
You wouldn't know. Not with a mother that you were raised like that. So you were recently divorced. Sorry to hear about that. What makes you now like, okay, now I'm ready to find the man of my dreams, ready to move past that and move to the next step?
I got married when I was young, and kind of we outgrew each other.
Yeah.
And, you know, I was on the dating scene, and it was kind of overwhelming. Like, being in a relationship for so long and just being to that one person, and then you go out there and you're trying to meet people, and you have to get to know people. And you have to, when you first meet someone, you're meeting that representation of them. You're not meeting who that person
is. Exactly.
And then, you know, then you got to go through all the you know, you just got to really get to know that person. And I just didn't want to go through that. And I felt like being on this type of show, I can actually, you know, meet that person. I knew what I was getting into, that person from what I thought, you know, I was ready to settle down.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, I thought I wouldn't have a fair chance.
And so everyone calls this the African-American version of The Bachelor. Sean Bullard is his name. And what was it that kind of attracted you to him?
Well, I couldn't say. Like, he seemed like a great guy. I didn't really get, as you can see from watching the show, and for those who haven't watched it, I really didn't get that much time with him.
Yeah,
He seemed like a nice guy. You know, I don't care about the whole, you know, he's a millionaire and all of that. That's not what I was interested in. I wanted to get to know him, but we never had a chance to go on a date. So, yeah.
And then his mother was there, and then Pastor Ken Johnson. How was it having them two, you know, all in the space?
I got along with his mother.
Good.
You know, we were there. I lived in a house for about a month. So,
yeah,
so with shooting the show, they had to edit out a lot. Cause we were.
I can imagine. Yeah.
You know, we were being recorded 24/7. And it was a lot of stuff that they couldn't show. But I had a great relationship with his mother.
Good.
You know, I got to know her, and she reminded me of one of my family members. I actually got to know his mother better than I got to know him.
Wow.
Yeah,
wow.
And Pastor Jay, you know, I can't say too much because there will be some stuff revealed about me in the next two episodes, so definitely keep watching, and there will be a time.
Okay. So how is it, I mean, you know, we hear the stereotype that women have a hard time getting along, and we, of course, you see some of the things that happen on the show, but being around 24 women, how was that experience? How do you adjust to that?
I played football. I've been an athlete my whole life, so I've always been around a lot of women, you know. So I'm pretty chill and pretty laid back. I don't bother anyone as long as they don't bother me.
Right.
You know, I respect people as long as they respect me. So I got along with pretty much everybody. I did have a couple issues, as you saw in the last episode. But, you know, I'm not going to let anyone disrespect me. So.
Right. Yeah.
But I'm a lady. So.
Exactly. And you deserve to be treated as one. So, going away from the show, What do you take from this experience of being on the show, shooting the show, filming it for them? You know, you say you were in the home for a month with all these people. What is your takeaway?
I met some beautiful women, beautiful on the inside and out. You know, women who will be my friends probably for the rest of my life. We went through that experience together.
Yeah.
You know, we had our crazy times, we had our fun times, we had our emotional times. I really wish the cameras could have captured it. Like, you went from laughing to crying to every emotion you experienced in that house.
Do you feel that the camera or, I know in reality TV, because I've been on the set of some shows where they do edit, you know, because of timing and sometimes for the reaction or whatever, do you feel like that you were depicted well on the show based on what actually happened while you were there?
Yeah, definitely.
Good.
I'm happy because I look at some of the other reality shows. Like, a lot of people are calling this show ratchet, which I don't agree to that at all. I feel like, you know, this is real life. You're in a house
right.
of 24 women. There are going to be issues, you know, and not everyone's going to react the same, you know.
Sure.
You know, I love that we were all successful women, you know, with what we did, and we were all ambitious. We were very opinionated, and it was real. I feel like a lot of reality shows are very scripted, and, you know, they set you up in situations, and, no, this was as close to real life as it could get. Like, you know, you're in a house with a bunch of women.
Yeah. And, you know, a lot of people who watch shows like this, or The Bachelor, The Bachelorette, they ask themselves, what is the reality of actually that person finding the one? You know, especially if they can see the man going on dates with other women, you know, making out with other women and kind of being intimate and that kind of thing. As a contestant or someone that's part of the show, is there any jealousy? Is there any, why is that not me? Or, I mean, did you get any of that?
I didn't get it. I'm not that type of girl.
Okay.
You know, I highly believe that what is meant for me will come. But, you know, I'm a hopeless romantic, and I do believe in love at first sight. Like, you can meet someone and just hit it off with that person. And, you know, and I believe that you can go on a show and find true love.
Yeah.
Like,
okay.
You feel it. When you meet that person, you feel it. Just some people,
that chemistry.
You know, they choose to look away, or, you know, maybe they're not ready for it. But I do feel like you can experience love at first sight. So I do think you could go on a show and find true love. And hopefully Sean found the one.
Hopefully he finds it. And you too. Now, explain this to me, because I know women all over the world are going to be a little curious about this. But you say that with your next man, your future man, you would be open to him having sex with other women as long as you knew before it happened. Tell us about that.
Well, so you have to understand, I was in a Muslim relationship, and it was, at first, you know, I didn't get it, but then, you know, it's once you let go of your ego and understand what love is about, then you can understand, like, you can be with a man and he can love you, and he just, you know, he just might need to have sex with someone else.
Okay.
But that doesn't take away his love for you. That doesn't mean that he doesn't love you.
Right. Because men and women love differently. They do love differently. Yeah.
And I'm not that type of person. I feel like when I'm with someone, I trust that person, and, you know, I'm big on honesty. And if I have that and I know where his heart is, that's fine. You can go do what you got to do as long as you come home to me at the end of the night and use condoms.
Right, yeah. Big thing there. You know, I think, but what you're saying, it goes back to the whole thing about the trust factor. You know, the fact that he's able to come to you and say, this is what I want to do, you're fine with that as long as he tells you, right?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, a lot of women are insecure. That's just how I see it. They're insecure and, you know, they think their man is going to leave them, or they think that, you know, their man might, that they're lacking something and that their man might find that in another woman. And but if it does happen, if he falls in love with her and he's happy, then I want him to be happy. It doesn't, you know, I just want that person that I'm with, I want them to be happy.
Okay.
And I feel like, you know, when you're in a relationship, that's what love is about.
Absolutely. Tell us, how would you describe, and we know no one is perfect, but in your, you know, who would be the perfect man for you?
The perfect man for me is an honest man.
Okay.
Someone who, you know, I can build with. Basically, I'm looking to build an empire with someone.
Right.
I'm looking, you know, you know, we balance each other out.
Okay.
And, you know, we can grow something together. And we have each other's back.
Absolutely. Well, listen, tell everyone where they can keep up with you and follow you on social media. I know that you have some very interesting things to say and post. Tell us where they can keep up with you.
Yeah, I'm Tanyka Renee. If you Google, you can find me on Twitter, Jock and Tanyka, JOCKINTANYKA. Facebook, Tanyka Renee. Instagram, Jock and Tanyka. And then TanykaRenee.com.
Well, Tanyka, thank you so much for taking the time. I appreciate you being on, and I know you're going to find that man that's going to be perfect for you. So thank you so much.
Thank you for having me.
All right. You have a good one.
You too. Bye.
Now you can watch Match Made in Heaven. It comes on Thursdays at 11 p.m. on WeTV. For more information about Tanyka Renee, go to our website, StephenKnightShow.com. We'll be right back after this.
You're listening to The Stephen Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. You're listening now. You're listening to The Stephen Knight Talk Show on EOTM Radio. The Stephen Knight Show, Monday nights at 10 p.m. Eastern Standard Time, only on EOTMRadio.com.
Welcome back. Now it's time to go on to Stephen's playlist. As you know, we receive music from people all over the country wanting to be featured. We select artists to play on our playlist, and tonight our songs are from independent and major artists, including Authentic and, of course, Jahna Sebastian, who is our guest tonight. If you're interested in being featured on the playlist, email us at submissions@thestephenknightshow.com. Attach one or two songs, your bio, and one or two promotional pictures. Remember, all songs must be edited for radio, meaning no cursing. You definitely look forward to hearing your work. The first song tonight is by Jahna Sebastian, entitled Do It For You. It's the remix. Check it out and enjoy Stephen's playlist.
We'll be right back. Superstar. Just the other day, you turned and walked away. Left you all alone, heart full of pain. Never said goodbye, put you there to cry. Broken down, standing in the rain. Hey, wipe all your tears away. Cause I can't save the day. Gonna give it the pain. Coming over to make sure you're okay. You don't have to wait. I'ma save the day. Call me Superman. You can go and play. Girl, I'm on my way.
Yeah, Ursha, baby, this is for the A. Shawty, I don't mind if you dance on a pole. That'll make you up. Shawty, I don't mind when you work until three. If you're leaving with me, go make that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. Cause I know how it is. Gon' handle your biz and get that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. You can take off your clothes, long as you coming home. Girl, I don't mind. The ballers and get them like they gon' buy 100 bottles. As soon as you shake it, I know they gon' make it colossal in here. Cause shawty, you thinkin' them tricks that you do with your body. Got all of these cutting around you like they sing Beyonce in here. You want your own and you need your own, baby. Who am I to judge? How could I ever trip about it when I met you in the club? I make enough for the both of us, but you dance anyway. You know I was raised in the A, shawty, I don't mind if you dance on a pole. That'll make you a shawty, I don't mind when you work until three. If you're leaving with me, go make that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. Cause I know how it is. Go handle your biz and get that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. You can take off your clothes, long as you coming home. Girl, I don't mind.
No, I don't.
When you get off of work, I'll be ready to go in no Rari. And when we get home, we'll have us our own private party, you know. So I don't worry at all about the things they do or say. I love you anyway. You can twerk while in the split. You racking up them tips. Your body rocking, your booty popping. I'm proud to call you my. They be looking, but they can't touch a shawty. I'm the only one to get it. So just go ahead, keep doing what you do. If you dance on a pole, that'll make you a shawty. I don't mind when you work until three. If you're leaving with me, gonna make that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. Cause I know how it is. Gonna handle your biz and make that money, money, money. Your money, money, money. You can take off your clothes.
Let's get it.
As long as you coming home.
Yeah. What you see, Jay? I'm just trying to cut her up, trying to bust a nut, trying to take somebody, trying to two, trying to fill my cup, trying to live it up, put some hundreds on that, got out the club. Yeah. Lap dance for the first date, better throw a few bands, that's third base. It's okay if you work late, we can still party like it's your birthday. We can still party hard in your birthday suit, like the out the park like my name Beirut. Shawty, she just want a tip, I just want to see a strip. If you like you love me, shawty, you might get rich. Have her own cake, her own place, blow her own gas, no Rolex. When we in the bed, she like the tell her friend to join in both ways.
Shawty, I don't mind. If you dance on a pole, that don't make you. I don't mind when you work until three. If you leave with me, cause I know you gotta make that money, money, money. Oh. Your money, money, money. Cause I know how it is. What? Girl, go and do your biz. What? Make that money, money, money. Make your money, money, money. Oh. You can take off your clothes.
Well, that was our show tonight. I want to thank our special guests, Jahna Sebastian and Tanyka Renee, for joining us tonight. Listen, you all at home, thanks for listening. Spread the word. God bless. Have a great week. Peace.
You came here to party, go on, put your hands up. If you want to get it started, go on, put your hands up. All my ladies in the front, all my thugs in the club. If you looking for some love, go on, put your hands up. Hands up, hands up, hands up, hands up. If you came here to party, go on, put your hands up. All my ladies in the front, all my thugs in the club. If you looking for some love, go on, put your hands up.
Hi, it's Jamie, Progressive number one, number two employee. Leave a message at the...
Hi, Jamie. It's you, Jamie. Don't be alarmed, but I think there's a guy following you. Maybe we should get that guard dog we talked about? Nothing too scary, maybe like a Bichon with an attitude? You know, Progressive's collision insurance covers injured dogs and cats at no extra cost, so... Wait, the guy stood up when I stood up. He's on the phone. He's looking right at me. Oh, wait, it's just my reflection. Don't tell anyone about this.
Progressive Casualty Insurance Company and Affiliates. Pet coverage not available in New Hampshire and North Carolina. Introducing the all-new 2018 Subaru Crosstrek at 2.9% financing on a Crosstrek today. Learn more at SubaruofKennesaw.com. Cannot be combined with any other incentive. Financing to well-qualified applicants. Subject to credit approval, vehicle insurance approval, and vehicle availability. No down payment required. See participating retailers for details. Offer expires 11/30/17.